What's up guys, just thought I'd do something fun and interesting today instead of the usual classic restoration video. So welcome to my Ford Ranger review. I'll be comparing three Ford Rangers today: the 2020 2-liter turbo diesel XLT 10-speed auto, the 2019 3.2-liter turbo diesel XLT 6-speed auto, as well as the 2020 2-liter bi-turbo Thunder 10-speed auto. First off, thanks to Ford Fury Woodmead for providing the stunning Ford Ranger Thunder double cab for this review, which will be on this particular video. If you are in the market for any of these Ford Rangers, the price for the 2020 2-liter 10-speed auto starts at around $589,000. The 2020 3.2-liter 6-speed auto starts at about $654,000. And the 2020 2-liter bi-turbo 10-speed auto Thunder version limited edition starts at about $757,000. In between, we have one of the best sellers, the Wildtrak, at 724,000, about 35,000 rand less than the Thunder. The Raptor of course tops the range at just under 900,000. The Ford Ranger Thunder is a limited edition Ford Ranger that boasts a new stylish aggressive grille with a distinct race red accent touches on the nostrils and throughout. The front grille makes it stand out on the road and definitely turns heads, and is slightly less aggressive than the Ford Raptor, which is arguably not for everyone. In terms of the lighting, it features the auto on and off headlamps and the daytime running LEDs, a feature which is not on the 2019 6-speed auto. The Thunder Edition comes standard with front heated windscreens as well as the new black alloy rims. The XLT versions come with quite a bit of chrome finishes such as the exterior mirrors, handles and rear bumpers, while the Thunder comes in these accent colors. Coming around the back, the Thunder comes standard with the hoop sport bar features that come fitted with the brake light illumination, whereas the XLT versions have the chrome roll bars as an extra. All models come standard with the central locking tailgate, which has lift assistance technology, making it 70% easier to lift. In the load bin, the Thunder comes standard with the new bin accessories such as the mountaintop roller shutters and the cargo management system, all covered under the 4-year 120km warranty, which helps with keeping your cargo dry but also compartmentalizing your bin. The 2019 models do not come with the 12-volt power point in the bin, but you will find this in most of the 2020 models. Under the hood is where it matters the most. You can definitely feel the difference between the 2-liter 10-speed auto and the 3.2-liter 6-speed auto. The 2-liter XLT 10-speed auto produces a maximum of 132 kilowatts of power and a maximum of 420 Nm of torque, whereas my personal favorite, the 3.2-liter XLT 6-speed auto, gives you a maximum of 147 kilowatts of power and a maximum of 170 Nm of torque. You can literally feel the engine beg you to go as you're in the driving seat, as it just keeps asking for more. Definitely not the best on fuel economy. It gets even better with the Thunder Edition bi-turbo engines, which is the exact same engine running the Wildtrak Edition, at a maximum of 157 kilowatts of power and a maximum of 500 newton meters of torque. The bi-turbo engine definitely gives you the best of both worlds. Good fuel economy with the power available when you need it. The engine is slightly quieter than the 3.2 liter and thus this is purely one of those driver dependent decisions. You will immediately notice the interior seats on the Thunder Edition are detailed with the red stitching as opposed to the burnt orange stitching on the Wildtrak. The center console folds down and offers the passengers two cup holders for the comfortable ride. Also a great feature if you have little ones with chocolate fingers is a dark roof lining on the interior of the Thunder as opposed to lighter versions on the XLTs. A very nice feature in the new models is the 230 volt power converter plug in the back seat, making your power needs a breeze. We jump right into the front seat. All the models come standard with a cool center console with a double lid and coin storage. Those who drive an automatic would certainly agree that a knee pad would be a thoughtful detail along the center gear lever area. The XLT versions offer four-way driver and passenger seat adjusters and lumbar support, whereas the Wildtrak and Thunder models offer eight-way seat adjusters also with lumbar support. The steering wheels are pretty much the same, however the Wildtrak and Thunder models go a notch further with safety features offering lane keeping assistance, adaptive cruise control, active parallel park assistance, forward collision warnings and autonomous emergency braking. All models come standard with an alarm system, a rear view camera and both front and rear PDCs. All three models feature the Sync 3 LCD touchscreen infotainment system, with a few minor resolution tweaks from the 2019 models. These come standard with navigation featuring Trax for Africa, Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. All models offer dual zone temperature control, which allows passengers and drivers to be in control of their environment. All in all, I'd say the Ford Rangers are giving the other buggies a run for their money on safety features as well as price. If you are in the market for a reasonably priced buggy with great features, then look no further. If you are in the market for a Wildtrak, I would recommend considering the bi-turbo engine or the Thunder Limited Edition styling pack instead for a little extra. As comfortable as the drive is on the bi-turbo, I'm a die-hard fan of the 3.2 litre 6-speed auto engine. If you are like me, Ford also offers the Thunder in a 3.2 litre 6-speed auto TDCi range as a limited edition. Thanks for watching and see you soon.